Good afternoon, please, you know.
Thank you, sir.
So, why do you wish to join the civil service?
Sir, civil services is my dream from childhood. And as a civil services give me opportunity to learn the differences. It will give me a more job satisfaction. And also, there is a diversity in a civil services. And I can serve the purpose, like the service to the nation.
Good. And what qualities do you possess which will make you a good civil servant?
Sir, I possess the qualities like learning ability, then leadership, that is leadership with a team play, honesty, integrity, empathy towards the downtrodden section, and also punctuality. And I believe in simultaneously become efficient and clean.
What about your rule of law? Did you uphold the rule of law?
Yes, sir, I uphold the rule of law.
You must talk of rule
yes,
of law.
Yes, sir.
And will you like to, don't you, would you not like to handle, be ready to handle crisis, or you run away from crisis?
No, sir, I will be ready to handle the crisis.
And you must mention these also.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Would you like to?
Mm-hmm. Mr. Satyawan, history was your optional subject.
Yes, sir.
Can you briefly tell something about the history of Maharashtra?
Yes, sir. Maharashtra has a long historical background. If you see from the early ages, like from Mahajan Pada, we can see there is a one of the Mahajan Pada Ashmuka, from what we call as the Ashmuka or Asaka, is from Maharashtra. Then afterwards in a Mauryan Empire, there is some naval ports like Sopara in Maharashtra. And after there is a Satavana kingdom, which is a very important kingdom in the second
coming
century.
To the independence struggle?
Yes, sir. Maharashtra has contributed a lot in a struggle of independence. We can see from a different perspective, like there are different leaders like social reformer like Mahatma Phule, then Savitribai Phule, and also we can see the extremist leader like Bal Gangadhar Tilak, and also revolutionary like Vasudev Balwant Phadke, Chapekar brothers, Savarkar brothers, and also moderate.
Which book you have read of late?
Sir, I read different type of books.
Which book you have read?
I am reading the book of Mahatma Phule, Shetkaran Chatur, Asu, that is the exploitation of farmers in the British era.
Do you think the farmers' condition has improved in independent India?
Yes, sir. We can see from the statistic that is the farmer condition is improved, but there are some element of distress like farmer suicide, distress in agriculture productivity, and also we can see from the different kind of droughts.
Why they don't get remunerative rise or return? Why they think farming is uneconomical?
Sir, there are different reasons. Like one of the reason is the middleman. Middleman is gaining the more of the profit from the farmers.
Anything done to improve irrigation facilities in Maharashtra?
Yes, sir. Maharashtra government it's come up
how
with
how much it has increased in last 7 years? Irrigation percentage.
Sir, now Maharashtra irrigation percentage is 18%. But Maharashtra is going with a scheme like the Jalyukta Shivar, and there is also contribution from civil society like NAM Foundation, Pani Foundation.
Knowledge of electronics, will it help you as an IAS officer?
Yes, sir, it will help. Sir, the recent government scheme like Digital India, then coming the electronic technology like 4th Industrial Revolution, in which we can use the Internet of Things for the welfare of a downtrodden section. Also, AI, artificial intelligence. Recently, Maharashtra government has launched the cloud computing policy, so we can provide the digital locker for the citizens. And also, recent move like Aadhaar, then biometric authentication process are used, then also JAM Trinity can be used. It all are the aspect of electronics.
Have you studied the central budget?
Yes, sir.
What is the size of the budget?
Sir, I am not recalling the exact number.
What are the focus areas?
Sir, our budget is focusing on agriculture, rural development, then also infrastructural development, also in a various section like industrial section, industrial growth.
Make in India, has it made any progress in?
Yes sir, Make in India has progress. We can see like in electronic sector, there are two set up by the Redmi company, mobile company in the Karnataka, and they are also going for another four setup.
Any bigger achievement?
Yes sir, there is a transfer of technology in the defense sector, but I am not collecting the exact
lessons. In the railway sector?
Yes sir, in railway sector, we are going towards a bullet trains and also to a hyperloop.
That is future.
Yes sir.
Anything achieved?
Sir, I am not exactly knowing. It is under the Make in India.
Okay. Manoj.
Yes, sir.
Your name is Manoj.
Yes, sir. My name is Manoj.
And what is Mahajan? It's a title.
Sir, it's my surname.
Oh, it's your surname. Okay. Jalgaon is your district.
Yes, sir.
Tell me something about Jalgaon.
Sir. Jalgaon is a district in the North Maharashtra. Mm. It is also known as a Khandesh. Mm. And it is well known for banana production. Okay. Also, it is known as a golden city in Maharashtra because it is famous for a gold sale. It gives the one of the most purified gold in Maharashtra. And also, it is famous for a local dialect, Airani.
Local dialect?
Airani.
Okay. Yes. It's separate from Marathi?
Yes, sir. It is a version of Marathi. It is a dialect.
Okay. Now, what are the major threats to our internal security in our country?
We can see in a different spectrum. There are threats like Naxalism, terrorism, and also militancy in Northeast. And also there are,
you call it insurgency.
Yes, sir.
Militancy, because militancy is a form only, but insurgency. Then what else?
Sir, we can see in other threat like the women security, also other vulnerable group security, minority security, casteism, communalism.
Casteism, regionalism.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This left-wing extremism.
Yes, sir.
When did it start and what is their philosophy?
Next-wing extremism start in 1960. In the Naxalwadi area of Bihar.
1967.
Naxalwadi
area.
Yes, sir.
And what is the philosophy?
Sir, their philosophy is mainly based on the Maoism, and they are not. They want a stateless society. That they are anti-establishment.
They want to overthrow government by violence.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Corruption is a menace. But what are the causes of corruption? Why are in administration and in corruption, the main reason?
There are causes from two sides, from the officer side and from the citizen side. We can see from officer side, there is a lack of accountancy, transparency, and also there is a not proper mechanism.
Don't say accountancy, accountability.
Accountability, sorry sir.
Then
there is a not proper mechanism of auditing, we can say, and also from citizen side, there is attitude like chalta hai, and also citizen are not aware about their rights because lack of information dissemination about their rights and citizen charter.
There are some mechanisms,
yes, sir.
Like law and acts,
yes,
as well as some institutions to prevent corruption,
yes,
in our country. Can you name them?
Yes sir, there are law like Prevention of Corruption
Act. Corruption Act,
Act.
Yes.
Then the institution like CVC, then CBI is also doing,
yes,
indirectly in corruption. Sorry sir, I am not able to recollect the all the
Enforcement Directorate.
Thank you, sir.
Lokayukt.
Yes, sir.
Lokpal. And then Act, Benami.
Benami Transaction.
And
yes,
Money Laundering Act. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yes.
There is a problem about Belgaum.
Yes, ma'am.
What was it?
The problem about Belgaum is historical.
Mm-hmm.
The unification of Maharashtra, in that moment, the Sayukta Maharashtra movement, Belgaum is a largely Marathi Marathi speaking
so
part of
Karnataka.
So why
did it come to Maharashtra?
Sorry, madam, I'm not.
It's not part of
Maharashtra.
Maharashtra.
It is
so,
part of Karnataka.
So why did it not come to Maharashtra?
Ma'am, I am not aware about the specific of the issue, but there is a negligence towards the Belgaum.
You've also done some work in crowd management.
Yes, ma'am.
So how did you manage the crowd?
Ma'am, it is a program of nearly 10 days.
Mm-hmm.
First, we are all having the some kind of form training.
So what training do you get from the police?
Ma'am, direct field training. That first few days we are at the traffic signal.
Mm-hmm.
Then afterward we getting the training is there, we are shifted to the more crowded area like famous Ganpati Mandal, and last day we are making the human chain to segregate the Dhol Patak and other siblings.
Now you also are interested in sport, so recently the government of India conducted some program.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you tell me something about this program?
Ma'am, recently government of India has came with a scheme, Hello India scheme.
Hello school for the school children.
Yes, ma'am.
Alright, so what happened there?
Ma'am, I am not aware about the specific, but they are focusing on group activities, group sports like football.
And lots of other activities also, all related to sports.
Thank you.
Now you also invested in astronomy. What
yes.
is astronomy?
Ma'am, astronomy is a science.
Mm-hmm.
We studied the extraterrestrial bodies like which are in the outer of the earth, outer space of earth. We studied their physical chemical properties.
So there was some discovery last year about some planets which
yes,
are earth like exoplanets. Can you tell me something about that? What was it?
Yes, ma'am. There is a discovery about the exoplanet
which is named
as a Trifset.
Trifset one.
Yes, ma'am. There are
now. So what have they been named, these planets? A's for the star and B2Hs for the different
yes,
planets.
Ma'am.
So what do we learn about these planets? What do we learn from them?
These planets are revolving around the red dwarf and they are tidally locked. That is, their only one face is always facing the star, and they can become the next time. They are in a habitable zone. That there can be a chances to evolve the day.
That's true. So you also write.
Yes,
what
ma'am.
Is the last issue you wrote on?
Ma'am, I am not writing the issue particularly, but I am writing the sarcastic poem on a trend. And
oh,
I
so
give them as a birthday gift.
And so do you publish them also? These
no, ma'am.
Poems?
No, ma'am.
All right. Now, I am going to ask you about some schemes.
Yes,
one
ma'am.
Is the air connectivity scheme.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you aware of this regional air connectivity scheme?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me something about it.
Recently, our Prime Minister has inaugurated Udaan scheme, Ude Desh Ka Aadmi. Desh Ka Aam Nagrik. Yes, ma'am. In which we are going to connect the regional, we are developing the regional airport,
and
which are already government.
Alright.
And also, in which there is a concession provided on a ticket line. There is a capping on a ticket, like for one hour travel, there will be a 2500 capping, and it is provided for a 50% seats of the particular aeroplane or air flight.
Okay, so what about the remaining?
Remaining on a market mechanism.
And how will the airlines try to cap this funding?
Ma'am, there is a viability gap provided by the government.
Alright. Now, we've seen a lot of disasters in Maharashtra. Whether it's earthquakes or it is floods. So do we have any agency which deals with disasters?
Yes, madam. We have National Disaster Management Agency,
mm-hmm.
NDMA.
Mm-hmm.
And also Maharashtra government is focusing on the first Metropolitan Disaster Agency in Mumbai.
So when there were Mumbai floods, who came to the rescue? The disaster agency or the citizens?
Ma'am, both came to the rescue.
Now, you were talking about cloud computing.
Yes,
what
ma'am.
Is cloud computing?
Ma'am, cloud computing is a basic concept that we don't have a proper storage network here.
Mm-hmm.
So, we can share the storage network of other agency by using the internet. So, it leads to the optimum utilization of our resources, and it also helps the company because they can focus their core issues like when they can they do not invest in the storing facility.
Okay, thank you.
So Manoj, how do you look at India-Nepal relations? Has there been any change of late?
Yes sir, India-Nepal relations are changing. Then according to Nepalese Prime Minister Mr. KP Ohli, he is focusing more on equality in a relationship. They are using the China's card, and also there is a lot of delay in our projects that are being inaugurated in Nepal. So there is a kind of change in Nepal.
But from India's side, have we made any significant offers to Nepal?
Yes sir, we have made a significant offer to Nepal.
What kind of?
Sir, we are going to invest in their hydroelectric projects in timely manner, and also India is offering the agricultural knowledge with a sharing of agricultural knowledge with Nepal. And also, we are going to have a railway connectivity, major railway connectivity with Nepal.
Anything else?
Sorry, sir, I am not remembering at this point.
Very soon, there is going to be a Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting.
Yes, sir.
Which will be attended by your Prime Minister.
Yes, sir.
What is the relevance of Commonwealth?
Commonwealth is an organization of intergovernmental organization of 53 countries, which are mostly the former colonies of British. Today importance is because after the Brexit, Britain is going to have more market in the world, and Commonwealth will be one of the largest market according to Britain. And also there are some issues like there is the importance of Commonwealth. We can see there is a queue to join the Commonwealth.
Okay. Now you have heard of BRICS.
Yes sir.
What is BRICS and what is the commonality of BRICS?
With common.
What is meant by BRICS?
BRICS is an association of five nations, Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa.
And what is the common thread?
The common thread can be all in the phase in the development. So, terrorism is one of the common thread.
Has there been any common initiative taken by this group?
Yes sir, they have taken a common initiative. They have made the various declaration. Previous, the Shanghai declaration related to women safety, and also the National Development Bank. New Development Bank.
Where is this bank located?
I am not exactly remembering the
location.
Thank you sir.
And has it undertaken any development projects? Has it financed any project?
Yes sir, it is financing the project in India. But I am not remembering the name of that project.
Okay, now what is the significance of 1991?
We changed from our socialistic economy to the more toward the liberalization, privatization, globalization.
So that Marshall and Mark, right? Yes. Is that process of liberalization complete?
No sir.
There are some unfinished
yes sir.
What are these unfinished agenda? Can you mention one or two areas where reforms are still required?
Sir, there are first generation reform and second generation, but we are unfinished with the second generation reform like labor reforms. And I am not remembering the other reforms.
Okay.
But
labor reforms, what are the unfinished issues?
In India, there is most of the sector is an unorganized sector. And I am not aware about the proper.
Have we done anything to undertake reforms in the labor sector? Has government done anything?
Yes, sir. We have done in last year. I am not exactly.
Different labor laws are being clubbed.
That is only 44 provision in there.
To simplify. Last question. What is demographic dividend?
Demographic dividend is the workable force which can be used skillfully in the industry.
Why is it called a dividend? What is the dividend part? Why is it called a dividend?
It is a major proportion of our population. So we can
contribute significantly to the nation building. production and all.
What is the size of Maharashtra's economy?
Sir, Maharashtra's economy is nearly about 400 billion.
How much is that?
$400 billion. That is nearly in rupees is 25 lakh crore.
No, I don't think.
Sir, I read it under the Maharashtra Government Global Summit. Global Investment Summit, in which the our CM has told about the size of Maharashtra.
Size is 19.84 lakh. 19.8, which means almost 20 lakh crores.
Yes, sir. I will say.
What is the per capita income of Maharashtra?
I don't know the exact numbers.
1,65,000.
Thank you, sir.
What is India's per capita income?
I read nearby it about 75 to 80,000.
Listen, 1,11,000.
Thank you, sir.
Read up. Niti Aayog had brought out recently a health index for various states as its place Maharashtra.
Sorry sir, I don't know.
Pretty high at number 6.
Thank you, sir.
What is the literacy rate in Maharashtra?
Sir, 82.099.
Correct, 82.9, not 09. It's almost 83.
Yes.
Sex ratio?
Sex ratio is 919. Sex ratio.
No, better, 9:9. What is the Indian ratio?
Sir, Indian ratio is
943. How many districts do you have?
Sir, Maharashtra has 36 districts.
Correct. Now you saw the budget of this year in Maharashtra?
Yes, sir.
What growth rate does it show?
Sir, growth rate decreased by the 3% point. That is, earlier it was 10%, but now it is 7.3.
Where is the maximum fall?
Sir, maximum falls in agriculture sector.
Agriculture. How much was it earlier? It was a restrained 20%.
Yes, sir.
But now there is a
minus 8%.
Yes, sir. Very steep fall.
Yes, sir.
In other words, agriculture is a very vital sector.
Yes, sir.
It can affect India's economy. It can also affect the state's economy. Yes, even of a highly industrialized state like Maharashtra.
Yes, sir.
Correct? Or not?
Yes, sir.
So, what is the size of budget this year of Maharashtra?
Sir, I am not remembering the exact figure. I will study it.
Doesn't matter. How many tribes do you have, Sioux tribes?
Tribes in Maharashtra? Sir, I don't know, but in our district there are nearly about 3-4 tribes.
No, there are more. 47 Sioux tribes. Minimum 57, there may be more, but 47 is the latest I heard.
Thank you, sir.
Now, what are the constitutional safeguards for these tribal people?
There are article right to equality.
Yes, 14.
14. Then there will be no discrimination on the basis of sex, race.
15.
Then article 16, that is in government of there will be equality.
Right.
There is a
article. Reservation of jobs will also be under 16. Reservation.
Yes, sir.
In government jobs.
Yes, sir. In 16, article 16, second provision.
Go ahead. What else?
Sir, there is also other provision like article, I think 342,
yes.
which is providing the list of the scheduled tribes, which can be promulgated by the our president.
And does article 19 also?
Yes, sir. Article 19 is. Because sir, article 19 is given to the all the citizens. That is the right to association, then right to freedom of expression.
No.
So we can use this platform to address their issues.
Restricted entry in tribal areas is under Article 19.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah? When government talks of exceptions, otherwise anyone can travel anywhere,
yes,
in the
sir.
Country. Non-tribal cannot buy the land of it.
Yes,
tribal.
Sir.
So he cannot acquire property,
yes, sir,
in a tribal area.
Yes, sir.
Those are the 19. 29 cultural rights. Remember these things. Now, Government of India has launched many successful schemes, many schemes like Ujwala,
yes,
etc., Swachh Bharat. Which, according to you, is the most successful scheme?
Sir, if you see the statistics, I think the Pahal Yojana, that is providing the LPG gas cylinder to the
Ujwala
Yojana, is the one of the most successful.
How much solar power is Maharashtra producing?
Sorry sir, I don't know the statistics.
The smart cities, what improvement do you see in these cities which have been selected as smart cities in Maharashtra? Tell me the actual improvement that is now.
Sir, I live in Pune, so...
That is why I asked you this question. What improvement in Pune, distinct improvement you see?
Sir, there is a project related to the bicycle, that use of a bicycle.
So, have they made the bicycle tracks?
Sir, they are making the bicycle track. It is in the process, but in the popular area or in the core area of the city, they have made the bicycle track.
Correct.
And
four companies have also started lending bikes, you know.
Yes, sir.
After all, you need bikes, so someone has to give a bike. So there are four companies which has come in the picture.
Yes, sir.
In other words, smart city will also generate employment.
Yes, sir.
And income for people. Alright, we close the interview here.
Thank you, sir.
I'll give you a little feedback. I think you have performed very nicely. You have been able to handle most questions nicely. Now, some of the areas where I would like you to pay close attention is, one is Maharashtra. Get as much facts as you can about Maharashtra, economy, etc. Second, history. Then electronics. In electronics, now they are talking a lot in the, I think, interview also about robotics,
yes.
Artificial intelligence, blockchain, 5G, IoT, you know,
yes, sir.
Drone technology, 3D printing, etc. All these things are important. Then some programs of Government of India, such as Make in India, etc. You were asked, also Make in India, you were asked, right? Then current affairs like Nepal, India, some important problems of the country like demography, there is not enough jobs. Then second is agriculture, farmers' distress.
Yes, sir.
I would also suggest you take a look at some important schemes of the government.
Yes, sir.
Like smart cities, Swachh Bharat, Digital India, Ujjwala, Saubhagya, etc. And finally, quality. Quality, there are 3-4 important subjects like basic structure concept. Our constitution is flexible or rigid. Federal quality with unique unitary form of features. And important judgments of Supreme Court. Recently, Supreme Court has given a number of judgments.
Yes, sir.
Very important judgments like privacy, triple talaq, euthanasia.
Yes, sir.
आप इस पे थोड़ा थोड़ा जरूर पढ़ लेना चाहिए. इतना पढ़ोगे then I think you will be very well informed. Good.
Thank you.
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel, and press the bell icon to never miss an update.